All right, everyone. Thanks for joining us here alongside Jenna Cottrell and Mike Catalana. I'm Dan Fates here on BuffaloPlus.com and the Buffalo Plus YouTube channel. Jenna, it's not raining sideways and you're at a Bills practice.
I'm actually hot right now in a sweater. Like, look at the sun. What is going on? Yeah, here in Orchard Park. The Bills feeling pretty loose this week. A lot of sunshine, I think, will do the players good. But we were outside today at practice. Yeah, I think this Bills team got their confidence back after beating New England, and they have a very tough challenge ahead this week in Seattle, but definitely a different vibe. I think the weather plays into it, but definitely last week's results do as well.
Yeah, last week it was 40-mile-an-hour gusts. This time it's supposed to be in the 70s and sunny. And it was interesting, Mike, because last week maybe Mike –
hang on, Dan. But that's because you had to be up there in the wind and the terrible weather.
No,
I'll be up there Sunday.
Oh, you. Oh, I thought you were talking about practice.
You know, no, I'm not talking about practice. I'm talking about the game itself. You know?
Yeah.
It'll be nice. It'll be calm. It'll feel September game.
Yeah, all right. Anyway, but it was interesting because, Jenny, you brought up the weather because last week, I don't know if people understood the sarcasm in a tweet that I had that Brian Daboll said last Friday they knew they were going to play the Patriots, a team that struggled against the run. They knew it was going to be 40-mile-an-hour winds. It was going to be rainy and cold. And he said we practiced two pass plays. The rest were all runs. Okay, Mike, there was some sarcasm in Brian Daboll's tone. I don't think he really only practiced two pass plays, but – what do you want the offensive approach to be in this game going up against Seattle?
Look, I don't think you run to maintain the clock and you throw, you know, just to score points. You can maintain the ball and the clock by throwing the football too, because that's how you get first downs. First downs is how you keep the ball. You keep the ball, you keep Seattle off the field, and you continue to try to score. I think their passing game is a weapon in Buffalo. I think he has the players that can make those plays. And, yes, it would be great to run it and run it on Seattle and keep them off the field. But I don't think you're going to do enough scoring to play that type of football. I want to see Josh open it up. I want to see him make some big plays. Honestly, I want to see him go down the field too. We haven't seen a lot of that. So I want to see the September Josh Allen offense and outscore Seattle.
You want to see let Josh cook. Is that what we're going to try and do here?
Yeah, because we know Russ is going to cook, right? Nobody can stop him. He is the, in my opinion, the best quarterback in the NFL. As good as Mahomes is, and as well as, say, the other guys have played, Roethlisberger, Tannehill, you know, any of the other group. He's the best quarterback in the NFL. No one stops him.
Yeah, and Jenna, Sean McDermott talked about going up against Russell Wilson today, as well as just the entire Seattle offense. And it was almost like he was at a loss for words, or he just kept it, like, really simple, right?
He really did. I mean, he respects every opponent, but usually he'll elaborate a little bit more on the teams and what they do so well. But he just kind of said, you know, Russell Wilson is a talent. He's exceptional. He's an MVP-caliber guy. DK Metcalf, he's fast, he's strong, he's big, he's tall. And Tyler Lockett's having a good season, too. So it was kind of actually interesting, considering usually I feel like Sean McDermott will pontificate a little bit more maybe about the team that they're going up against. And I don't know if that's intentional that he's saying we respect this team that's coming in, but maybe don't want to overblow it. But at the same point, it was definitely a different message than I feel like we've heard from Sean McDermott. But, like, let's be real. Obviously, it's an incredibly talented Seattle team that's coming in here. And I don't think anyone overlooks, like, the guys that will be here on Sunday. But definitely different kind of messaging, I thought, at least, from McDermott.
Yeah, and I thought there was two interesting injury reports he gave. Obviously, John Brown not practicing, Jenna, as well as Matt Milano not practicing. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, you know, we did see Mitch Morris. He's in concussion protocol. He was out here working. I mean, Milano and John Brown are huge to this team. They're important playmakers on the offense. I don't know if the game plan for a guy like Milano and even John Brown is to have them be more limited throughout the week, not practicing, and then have them be on a limited snap count come Sunday. I mean, I think with Milano, he is that important to your defense and has shown to be that important that maybe that's what you do as he gets better and more healthy throughout the season. I'm not sure, you know, it is only Wednesday, but at the same point, it is interesting to see those guys not be practicing because of how key and influential they are in the Bills, both offensively as well as for John Brown. Brown, or excuse me, John Brown offensively and for Milano defensively.
Yeah, and Mike, I feel like we say this all the time, but the Bills haven't played exceptionally well their last two games. Now you're going up against one of the best teams in the NFC. Another measuring stick game? Like, I feel like at one point, Josh and the Bills to beat these teams that they are – that are playoff, that are championship caliber teams. Like you've said before, to be the best, you got to beat the best, right?
Yeah, and you're right. And I don't think they have really passed those tests. They won games the last two, but they didn't pass a test against New England. They survived. And obviously we know they didn't do it against the other teams. Seattle is a measuring stick. I will say this. I'm going to go back to my old line. It's not – necessarily who you play, it's when you play them. I like the scheduling for the Bills because Seattle's coming off a division game, and then they follow this with two more division games. And picture you're a Seattle Seahawk, and in the middle of this, you're flying to Buffalo. They have no connection to Buffalo. And I don't think the Bills are necessarily a team anybody takes for granted, but I do believe the Bills could be catching them at a good time. Now, at the same time, it's still Russell Wilson. And I don't consider DK Metcalf an actual player in the NFL. I think of him more as a cartoon character. He's what is he, 7 feet, 400 pounds, and runs the 40 in 1 second. Yep. Like, right? He's not a normal human being. He is incredibly physical. Yeah, it really is. And then, you see the plays he's made. He's been unstoppable. So I'm not dismissing how good Seattle is, but they've been in tight games with some bad teams. They've been in tight games with good teams. That's a Seattle team. That's normally what it is. But I like the timing of the Bills game with them. I think Seattle coming east this week is a real plus for the Bills.
Yeah, it should be interesting. The Seattle offense, really good. Their defense, really bad. So we will have to wait and see. We will have more coverage throughout the week on BuffaloPlus.com as well as the Buffalo Plus YouTube channel. So make sure to like and subscribe. For Jenna Cottrell in a rare sunny Orchard Park and Mike Catalana, have a good one. We'll see you next time.